Hi friends, welcome to Learn and Explore. Today's topic is about Road Estimator Software. In the previous video of Road Estimator, I discussed about design layers, and today I will discuss about the dynamic table in Road Estimator, so the area table. So you are requested to watch the previous video so that you can understand whole the topic. So for dynamic table, you have to go to the report menu and then you will find dynamic table. So first this table configuration box will appear. And here in the define table, you have to go to this define table, and then create table dialog box will appear. In this create table dialog box, here is the option of number of columns. I have put in 9 and the number of rows are 4. So in offset in X and offset in Y is nothing but the position of the area table in the cross section. You can also put this offset X and offset Y later also, or in the specify screen also. Average column width I'm giving 2, and average row height I'm giving 0.06, and the text height as per your requirement, normally I'm giving 0.3, and the precision, you know, I'm giving 0.000. so check mark on these two field and then create. Then you will get the table preview. So I'm giving the first row name as area table, and in the second option I want to put all the layers. First I'm mentioning the side, and I have two sides, left hand side and for LHS left hand side, and for RHS right hand side. And now I will put the material name BC, that is bituminous concrete, then DBM, dense base macadam, and this WMM. I have two layer of WMM, so I'm giving WMM2. And in the next column, I'm giving WMM1. So in the next column, I'm putting GSB. Okay. And subgrade. And I will use the cutting and filling quantity. I also want to display the cutting and filling quantity. So I'm giving cut and the fill. You are requested to watch the previous video. Otherwise, you can't understand this video. Okay, so I will put the link in the description and also in the top. Okay, now in the to show the area of bituminous concrete, so you have to press F10 in your keyboard. For that, the offset selection will appear. Okay, so in the F9 it is offset selection, and if you press F10, then the variable selection will appear. In this variable selection, you will find design layer area. And this is 1:1 BC. You have to choose 1:1 BC, because I have created the left side group LHS for the first one. So this is 1:1, and for the RHS it will be 1:2. Okay, so that's it for left side group. You have to choose 1:1 and the design layer, and for right side group you have to choose 1:2 and the layer you want to give. So in this way you have to keep all the design layers. Okay, and the symbol is dollar symbol. Okay, $1:1 the design layer name. So again, you are requested to watch the previous video of Road Estimator. Okay, there I have discussed about the design layers, and these layers I have created, this BC, DBM, WM, GSB, subgrade, etc. So I'm giving the subgrade right side. This 1:2. Oh, I did a mistake. Okay, so in the GSB I have to choose F10 and the design layer, and 1:2 GSB. So this is the right option. Now in the cut option, I do go to the field, defined field layer area. Okay, this field layer is a different topic. I will discuss it in the next video. Okay, till now I use this chart, embankment cut and embankment field. Okay, so this is a field layer. In you can also go to the configure and field layer option, then you can get that options of cutting and filling quantity. So I have created this area table. Now I will draw a horizontal line. Here is the option to add a horizontal line. And again, for the row 2, I am adding the horizontal line, and this for LHS and for RHS, this is the horizontal line. Okay, so I made all the settings, and here it is X offset and Y offset. You can specify intersection location. Here is the option I told you about this. You can also specify this intersection point where you want to put the table, where you want to put the dynamic table. So you can choose this option. So I'm choosing this option. Automatically the X offset and Y offset will change. Okay, otherwise you can put it manually. And don't forget to save this. Okay, first, if you also want to change the width of this row height and the column height, okay, then you can change this by changing row height. And I'm putting 0.6 only, or you can also change the column width. Okay, so that's it. You must have to save this drawing and then close. Okay, so after that, to process the data, go to the click the process link and the process data. After processing, the cross section will appear. Yes, see, this area table is created, and all the cross sectional area I get this for each and every layer. I get the cross section layers areas. Now it is very helpful for not helpful. This is mandatory for quantity calculation in road work. Okay, so if you interested that you want to learn more, then please comment in the comment section so that I can give you more details about road estimator. Okay, and do subscribe our channel for related to AutoCAD, Excel. Thank you for watching this video and keep supporting us. Thank you.